At the outset, we have a concept but no detailed design, no firm technology choices, so the enterprise architect has to work with the customer service domain business architect and put together this context diagram and show how the concept of this smart chat bot will actually fit into the current landscape. It shows who will interact with it, both people and other systems, identify interaction and interfaces, and illustrating diagrammically a business function view of the new system in its wider business context. This is used to get approval from the investment board to proceed with the first design and development sprints. Before they give the go-ahead, they seek assurances that the right resources are available. This chart shows all of our change initiatives, and all those colored red have automatically been flagged as a resource conflict that needs resolving. Fortunately, we can see that the initiative is free of conflicts, and the Asia sales development team can start its work. Referring to the published design patterns, which we'll cover more in use case 4 when we cover governance, the team solution architect picks up the context diagram and fleshes it out with the components that will be needed to turn the concept into a functioning system. They're using Ardoq support for the C4 modeling diagrams, which is a design standard the company has adopted for consistency across the organization. Here's the level 2 container diagram, which shows how the smart chat is broken down into components, what they do, and how they will communicate with each other. We can also see here that the team's data architect has identified the components that will be processing sensitive information. The in and outbound references in the context diagram we saw before are now connected at the more detailed level in the application modules. Had any new connections been identified, this would have triggered a change at the higher level, alerting the business architect of a change to the higher level of the context view. Ardoq's consistency between the C4 modeling levels is promoting communication and collaboration between the different teams and roles involved, whether that's the solution architect, the business architect, the enterprise architect, or the business sponsor and the software designers. Now we come to the describing of the technology choices and how Ardoq supports options evaluations. In this case, the solution architect wants to develop two options, one developed with AWS services and the other with Azure. Here's the Azure view, showing which Azure services are being used by which solution components. And we can see that the Azure AI Foundry, highlighted here in yellow, is not yet an approved standard. We can also see that our DevOps team have added the label that will be used to allocate Azure resources when this solution comes live. We'll come back to that, how that works later, but it's important to note that Ardoq scenarios will allow the users to create multiple future scenarios. And these are used, in this case, to develop the two options, AWS or Azure. To save time, we're just going to focus on the one which is the Azure option, but the same process will be followed by the team that is creating an alternative AWS option. Clicking here generates a scenario from the current view, representing one possible future scenario. Remember that this is a data-driven branch, so we'll be able to actually track those changes over time. When one of these is finally chosen and implemented, that scenario can be re-merged stepwise as the implementation rolls out into the mainline model, and the others can be archived. For the smart chat, our two options are brought before a review team, and a lightweight evaluation is conducted using Ardoq's solution health check process. We'll see how that works more detailed in the use case 4 as we cover governance. It results in the decision to go ahead with the Azure option, as it is better aligned to our technology strategy. And this decision is alongside other decisions being recorded as an architectural decision or an architecture decision record. It is then linked to the application component. We'll see these later and in more detail as we cover these in use case 4. So now we've agreed upon a solution architecture. The software development teams can work on the detailed designs of each element. Software designers can do this work adding their component diagrams, which are level 3 in the C4 modeling hierarchy, using Ardoq by following the same approach we saw when the solution architect added level 2. But as is common in many agile development teams, this one prefers to manage their own documentation in diagrams using Lucidchart. So now we'll export this level 2 view as a Lucidchart. It's important to note that during this process, we're maintaining the data behind the diagram so that we can round trip this data and all changes that are being diagrammed in the Lucidchart instance. By allowing them to use the tool of their choice, we empower them to make the designs they need to do with the tools that they're comfortable with. And the best part is allowing them to use the level 2 designs gives them a starting point for their more detailed design work. When it comes to linking detailed solution designs and documentation, we have more options that offer support to different ways of working and styles of governance. Development teams and software designers can create dynamic links from their charts back to the higher components in Ardoq, allowing for a smooth transition from EA model views of the organization and its estate to the locally managed documentation of each product or development team. A more centralized approach might seek to represent lower levels of designs as components in the Ardoq model. To facilitate this, we can actually take the design diagrams from Lucid and turn it back into graph components and references in Ardoq. So to demonstrate that, we're going to select the Ardoq Lucidchart visual importer, which allows us to select an existing Lucidchart for import. In this case, we're loading a preloaded one to save time, but you can see how we can help the AI system interpret our diagram and give it the assistance necessary in order to be able to interpret any type of diagram being imported into Ardoq. We can review the system's interpretation, correct any mistakes, and manage the import. We can see that it has correctly used the legend in the diagram to assign each component the right type. We can perform a similar check on the references it has identified and either manually correct them or, if necessary, ask it to have another attempt, perhaps even changing the prompt so that it has a better direction. This one looks actually pretty good, so we'll proceed with this import right into Ardoq. Opening up a workspace shows us the model we've just imported, represented now as an Ardoq component and references that can be linked to the rest of our enterprise architecture knowledge graph. So we've gone from structured design in Ardoq data into an unstructured environment, designed a deeper level, and round-tripped it back into structured data into our graph. Once we have a more detailed solution design, the ARB may commission a detailed trade-off analysis of the solution to identify any concerns or gaps in the design. In this case, the review team has highlighted concerns about the level of skills available to support these new technologies in our company and the possible impact that might have on the system's reliability. We focused on how the enterprise, business architects, and solution architects, and the others in the product and design development teams collaborate on the design using Ardoq's core platform and its integration with their design tools of choice. It is also important that the EA team and other stakeholders, such as other product managers, can see this initiative in the context of the strategic priorities. They can track the progress of this initiative via Ardoq's Discover platform. This timeline view shows all the AI capability deltas that have been planned. We saw this being developed in the use case 2 advanced road mapping as part of our capability-based planning. Here we can see that the smart chat implementation initiative and our integration with Jira ensures that up-to-date progress data is being published and shared. It is broadly on track, but we can see that the integration with the mobile platform is being blocked. You may have noticed that this integration was a concern in the architectural review we saw earlier. Now we're approaching go live, so let's bring everything together into one view. This is the type of thing that might be presented to the ARB before we go live. We can see the patterns that have been applied, some of the architecture decision records, one of which is still waiting approval. The technologies used by each of the components, a summary of the health check we just saw, and sensitive data being processed by this new system. This viewpoint can be displayed at any stage, providing the ability to audit progress and view outstanding risks, issues, approved technical debt, and design decisions. You might have remembered back when we were looking at the design for the Azure implementation of the smart chat that we added a tag by our DevOps team to allocate resources. We'll finish with a quick look at how that helps us once the solution is live and operational. Cloud infrastructure is by nature dynamic. It can change according to demand, so there is no point expecting technical architects to model every service instance. It will be out of date before they've even finished, and they'll spend their lives chasing their tails. This is where our integration with Azure comes into play. The tag added by the DevOps team allows us to generate, on demand, a current view of the Azure services that are currently hosting the smart chat. And of course, that can be applied to all of our cloud-hosted services, ensuring that Ardoq and our views in Ardoq are always current, and reducing the amount of unnecessary modeling work from our EA teams or our cloud teams. And that concludes our overview of Ardoq support for solution design and delivery.